It's my honor to welcome you to the Los Angeles County Teachers of the Year recognition event. This is our 39th year of hosting this signature event, nearly four decades of celebrating great teaching and great teachers in our county. This year is very special. We are paying tribute to our teachers who are rising to the challenge of this pandemic. Our communities have come to have a deeper understanding of and a much deeper appreciation for all that our teachers do for our children every day. Teachers are incredible on a good day, but now we're all distance learning. Teachers send virtual lesson plans and prep Zoom calls or record videos of themselves reading or just being silly or trying to connect with our kids in a new and meaningful way, all while caring for their own children who are also learning from home. It's amazing how you have achieved great things despite the difficulties. I've read the testimonials from your superintendents, principals, parents, and fellow teachers about your incredible efforts, the great innovations and new practices you are pioneering, and new partnerships and relationships you're building to keep your students learning and thriving. Teachers are superheroes. Last year, we were delighted when one of our top 16 Teachers of the Year was named as a California Teacher of the Year. Guy Myers is an exceptional drama and musical theater teacher at John Burroughs High School who's made a profound difference in the lives of his students and their communities. I'm proud to introduce California Teacher of the Year, Guy Myers.
Hi, my name is Guy Myers. Wait, I can't be wearing this for my speech. Much better, but I'm not crazy about the red. Let's try again. Perfect. Hi, my name is Guy Myers. Welcome to my drama classroom. I wish we could all be together to celebrate what we love about education and the art of teaching, but I'll look on the positive side and say how cool it is that you get to see inside my drama classroom. I was a drama geek ever since I was a little kid doing skits in the living room at my grandparents' house. And I was a loud kid. But it wasn't until I got to high school that I learned how to use my voice and share my story. And that's because of my incredible drama teacher, Barbara Van Holt. We all know the power of that one great teacher in a student's life. To me, acting is essentially the ability to play make-believe. And when kids enter my classroom, I want them to forget worrying what other people think about them and just lose themselves in the art of storytelling. Storytelling is unlike any other art form. You get to share through a monologue or a scene or a play, a character's struggle. And by watching that as an audience member, we develop empathy and we learn more about something we didn't know anything about. And that's what I want my students to do with each other. I want them to be free to share who they are, to express themselves creatively, and to create an empathetic and supportive classroom environment. That's the most important thing to me. There's nothing quite like entering a drama classroom. The personalities are diverse and bursting with energy, and the excitement in the room is palpable. And yes, if you enter the room, it's very loud. But I don't hear it as loud. What I hear are the sounds of students running lines with each other, students practicing a funny bit of physicality, students going over a bit of choreography or running lines right before their performance that day. So when you first enter, you might think, wow, it's really loud. But what I hear are the sounds of family. And our family really supports one another. It is definitely not uncommon for a student to have stage fright when they first take the stage. And what you'll hear are the kids cheering them on saying, you can do it. I'll never forget Zachary in drama one, having a monologue and just racing through all the dialogue to get to the end of the speech so it could be over with. But then by his senior year, he got up in front of the entire school and gave the graduation commencement speech. Or Veronica, who was the shyest girl in class, but once she got on stage and you gave her something to do, like be a pirate finding buried treasure, she just immediately burst to life. and then also Misako, an ELL student with a stutter. We all worked with her so she would feel comfortable and confident when it came to her one big line, and she ended up doing it perfectly. And also Owen, a student on the spectrum who doesn't participate in any of his classes except for here in drama because he feels welcomed. He feels like he can be himself and he wants to participate with us. I love the start of the new year and the challenge of winning over every kid in the room. I'll never forget one of my favorite students, Emily, when she first entered the room. She sat in the back and all the kids were filling out a very short student bio sheet that I give them, but she wasn't filling it out. And I walked back there and I said, Emily, why aren't you filling out the paper? And she said, I was put here by accident. This is a mistake. I don't think I belong here and this just isn't my thing. Challenge accepted, Emily. I had 45 minutes to win her over. Once we got on our feet and started playing improv games, you could see her fall under our magic spell. The kids started to welcome her in, include her in the game. She started laughing and participating, and I saw this student change in front of my eyes in 45 minutes. On her way out the door, she handed me her student bio sheet and she said, I think I'm gonna give it a try. And that's what all of us want, all of us teachers. All we want is for our students to say, I'm gonna give it a try. That's what we're looking for. In an effort to teach tolerance, we all raised our voices in 2017 when we put on a production of The Laramie Project, which is the true account of Matthew Shepard, a young gay man who was kidnapped, beaten, tied to a fence, and left there to die. It got a wonderful dialogue going between all the students and the parents and community about bullying and how we as a society can be better listeners and how we can learn to speak up for ourselves when we need help, because not everybody knows how to do that. Recently, our school was coping with the suicide of a student, and some drama kids wanted to do something that could help. They wanted to create a piece of theater. Together, they wrote a play called A Day in the Life, which was a series of short scenes dealing with mental health issues facing teenagers, such as suicide, bullying, test anxiety, homelessness, drug and alcohol addiction, and peer pressure and the pressure of social media. Then at the end of the play, they all turned and looked at the audience and said, "Are you listening?" "I'm definitely listening." They got so much attention that other schools started to invite them to come and present scenes from their play and to share the process that they had created for how to make theater happen. I couldn't have been prouder than at that moment. The drama students also organized a rally on campus to promote gun safety and gun legislation. And they created an event that got so much attention that Adam Schiff showed up and made a speech. They saw firsthand that by raising their voices, they could be heard and they can make a difference. That's what I want them to learn, how to use their voices to make a difference. Right now, more than ever, we have to try to create these safe spaces for our kids. We need to figure out how to reach through the camera and pull them to us and inspire curiosity and creativity and critical thinking. I know we can do it. Congratulations to all the new teachers of the year. And I just want to tell you, I can't wait to learn from you what you have found to be successful in your classroom. My name is Guy Myers, and I approve this message.
Thank you so much, Mr. Myers, for those inspiring words. Each year, school districts across California select their own teachers of the year. These are amazing individuals who exemplify the excellent teaching and learning that takes place throughout Los Angeles County. Before we unveil our top 10 Teachers of the Year, let's take a moment to honor the amazing District Level Teacher of the Year honorees for 2020-21. I also want to take a moment to send a special message to the family of Karina Owen, Pomona's Teacher of the Year, who lost her battle to cancer in April. Thank you for sharing her with the students and community of Pomona Unified. Our thanks to all of you for your dedication to our young people. Before we introduce this year's top 10, I'd like to acknowledge our Greater LA Education Foundation for supporting our work to honor our teachers who are rising to the challenge during this unprecedented time. I'd also like to thank the platinum sponsor of this event for many years now, the California Credit Union. I'd like to introduce Gloria Rogers, VP, School and Community Development, who will say a few words.
Hi, I'm Gloria Rogers, Vice President of School and Community Development for California Credit Union. It's an honor to be here with you today to celebrate our amazing teachers throughout Los Angeles County. Your dedication to your students and your profession is more important than ever. We thank you for the impact that you make on the lives of students every day. Congratulations, 2020 County Teachers of the Year.
We're excited to welcome new partners this year, including Arizona State University, who has joined as a presenting partner for Teacher of the Year. I'd like to introduce Arizona State University President, Michael Crow.
Hi, Michael Crow here, President of Arizona State University. Plato was a teacher. Pasteur was a teacher. Madame Curie was a teacher. Teachers are it. Teachers are everything. The teachers that I had changed my life. We so support the teaching profession. We were a teacher's college, grew up as a teacher's college. We are deeply committed to the success of our region, which is Southern California and Arizona. We're deeply committed to you, deeply committed to the process of innovation, deeply committed to helping teachers to be empowered so that we can drive social transformation. We are an institution all about changing the world in every possible way, not by just running an educational institution, but by driving innovation through the educational institution into the society overall. We are unbelievably excited about being able to recognize the best teacher. I ask all of you that want to know more and learn more about what we're doing to visit our websites, email me, michael.crow@asu.edu, and we're all in about making this part of the country ever more successful through teachers. Thank you.
Innovation.
Hi, Michael Crow here, President of ASU. Innovation is critical to the success of our society in all things. New medical technology, new communications technology, new ways to teach, new ways to learn, all these things. And what we found here at ASU and what's so important to us is that we're finding ways to take a world-class research university and connect it with everyone. That's a process of cultural evolution and innovation. That's a process of technological innovation. That's a process of changing how we're doing things. And so we're very excited about our ranking for the sixth year in a row as number one in innovation. And what it means is we're going to be able to reach more people with more teaching, learning, and discovery, empowerment, using every innovation imaginable. So that's what this is all about. And I just want to say thank you to the teams at ASU that have really been able to make this happen.
Our thanks also go to Lakeshore Learning, who have been a regular sponsor of this event. I'd like to introduce Mark Funston, Senior Regional Manager.
Mark Funston here. As your local Lakeshore representative, I could not be more excited to be a part of LACO's 2020 Teacher of the Year celebration. And to all of this year's nominees, many, many congratulations. And on behalf of everyone at Lakeshore, we salute your hard work, your dedication, and your achievements. It's teachers like you that make us proud to be a part of the vibrant education community here in Los Angeles and all across the country. Please know that we at Lakeshore are here to support you, even from afar, and especially during these challenging times. Thank you for giving me the opportunity to participate in today's celebration, and please do not hesitate to be in touch if there's anything at all I can do for you.
We also want to thank our amazing Board of Supervisors, the Honorable Hilda Solis, the Honorable Mark Ridley Thomas, the Honorable Sheila Kuhl, the Honorable Janice Hahn, and the Honorable Catherine Barger for providing resolutions to all our 2020-21 Teachers of the Year. We also want to acknowledge the amazing individuals who judged the Teacher of the Year competition, all of whom have been past Teachers of the Year. Thank you all for your contributions to today's event. Here with us today are 10 of Los Angeles County's top teachers. They teach everything from math, English, engineering, social studies, and elementary school. The 10 county winners we are about to announce also have the opportunity to be named California's Teacher of the Year in the state competition, which will take place next month. One of those state winners will be chosen to represent California in the National Teacher of the Year program in the spring. And now, let's hear from our teachers. I will now read the names of our 10 county winners, alphabetically by district. These are teachers who have been judged by their peers as shining examples of this noble profession, after a countywide competition open to all public school teachers from pre-K through grade 12. Over the course of two decades at Antelope Valley Union High School District, Timothy Green has taught automotive and engineering courses at Palmdale High School and most recently public service, engineering, and robotics at Highland High School. Today, he continues to serve his students as a Skills USA advisor that has produced over 50 state champions.
I knew early on that I wanted to be an educator. I went through a high school program that was career technical education related to agricultural sciences. I got inspired by the hands-on work we did there along with the learning in the classroom. And I just realized that it could be just what a great opportunity to teach kids how to learn that way. Each of these students is having a brand new learning experience with you. You know, you might have taught the same lesson for the last 10 or 15 years and updated it with new technology and new ideas, but it's the first time that they've gone through that concept. You know, one thing that I've incorporated into my lesson plans is more current events. In education, if we don't provide relevance or concepts for the kids to apply, then a lot of the learning gets lost. With what I teach, we're seeing a lot with wildfire and emergency situations that are out there, and I've incorporated a ton of that into my teaching to where kids really understand the world around them. You know, these days they feel really isolated and alone, but as they take a look at what's happening, globally and nationally, it really helps them to gain some perspective on, the fact that we're all in this together.
As an immigrant and English learner, Maria Sims understands the true impact teachers have. You will find Maria engaging with her students in class during lunch, after school, and even on Saturdays for math tutoring. Maria is committed to bridging the achievement gap at Azusa High School.
When I started school, I didn't speak English. And so my teachers had to be patient with me. They had to help me, and they did. They motivated me a lot. And I got to see like what it feels like to have somebody in your corner, to have somebody not give up on you, to have somebody help you. I chose to become a teacher because I want to give that back. And I also choose to work at schools where I could help bridge the achievement gap. I feel like teaching is just amazing. I love doing it. I love teaching my students. They teach me a lot. I feel it's because of them that I continually want to improve myself, but I continually challenge myself. And so they inspire me every day to try my best.
In Wendy Bayan's classroom, it's not just history that's taught, it's life lessons. Wendy incorporates fun activities like Talk to Me Tuesdays and Work Habit Wednesdays. She's created a safe and welcoming space for her students for 16 years.
The biggest thing is that I enjoy the most is working with the kids. As just a teacher in history, I get to teach them things that they didn't know about. And I get to see when that light bulb turns on and just seeing when they're able to accomplish something or remember something or be able to learn how to write the essay the correct way. But it's more than just what happens in my classroom during my class time. You know, I'm a National Honor Society advisor. You know, I host a couple of clubs. I've done the class advisor thing. And I think that just the engagement and the interaction that I get with the students and, you know, giving them advice and helping them out and being able to kind of guide them in the right direction. I think that just, it makes things so much more fulfilling. I enjoy my job every day. When I go in, you know, it's, there's never a day that I dread going in. You know, it's not always the best, but I really do love my job. I love working with the kids and being able to teach them something that I'm passionate about also.
Erica Dent's commitment to continued achievement for her students is rooted in addressing their social emotional needs. Through her ELA, math, art, social studies, science, or PE class, her teachable moments go beyond the academic, and she seeks to create a space for students to be themselves and make mistakes.
Every morning when my class comes on, you know, I just greet them, you know, by name. And when the majority of the class is on, I'm always like, how are you feeling today? Just, you know, show me with your thumb. How are you feeling? And, you know, most students are thumbs up. Some are sideways or down. And we, you know, we just have a conversation. Like, I'll just say, like, Sally, what's going on? You know, sideways thumb or thumbs down. And, you know, most of the time it's just, I'm tired today. And, you know, we have that conversation, like, who else is tired? And I really like those, like, first, like, 10 minutes of just class, because we just get to talk and check in with our feelings. And I feel like that's very important for us to start our day that way. We get to just chat with each other and let each other know how we're feeling and encourage each other. So I would say that that's definitely been a highlight for distance learning. And we all can kind of be vulnerable. Like I tell them, you know, when I'm kind of having an off day, and, you know, our goal is to hopefully have thumbs up by the end of the day.
At Keppel Academy, Anna Palisa is involved in every club or after-school activity you can imagine, including the yearbook club, video production club. She's a Girl Scout leader and the school's English learner coordinator.
My advice to anyone considering the teaching profession, whether it's switching or starting out in the profession, is to make sure that you're not doing it for the money, for one thing. You have to be doing it because it's in your heart, that you really want to share with students, impart a little bit of yourself to them, and also be open and willing to listen to who they are, figuring out who they are, giving them what they need. And you know, I'd really advise that you have to have the heart for teaching. You have to be willing to be flexible. You have to be willing to differentiate for every kind of need. You have to be willing to go the extra mile, meet with parents, meet with brothers and sisters. You have to really kind of get to know the family, which is something that I really enjoyed about working in the district I work in. I actually have siblings that were babies when I taught the older siblings at another school. So I move schools, but not communities. So it's just you've got to be willing to be a part of who they are and be willing to learn a lot from students, not just think that you're imparting all the knowledge, because that's not the way it works. And you have to be willing to work hard to find exactly what students need to get where they need to be for the future.
Rhiannon Chavez teaches English language learners and is a reading recovery teacher through her Intensive Diagnostic Education Center affiliation. Rhiannon prides herself on building healthy relationships with her students and their families. Through upholding high expectations and active learning experiences, Rhiannon students have continued to thrive academically and artistically.
A couple weeks ago, I had a student's mother reach out to me on social media. And this student, I had her in 2016. She was in fourth grade. She left in the middle of the year. And now this little girl is in eighth grade. She lives in Atlanta, Georgia. And her mother reached out to me and said, "My daughter talks about you all the time. You were her fourth grade teacher. Can she please FaceTime you? Can we have a conversation with you?" And I said, "Absolutely." So it was me, the mom, the little sister, and my student, Angie. It's that, those moments that drive me to be an influence, to be positive on a student's life. That's like, it makes it all worth it. It makes all the hard work, all the challenges, all the struggles worth it. Being a champion for a student, that's what it is. That's what teaching is all about.
In addition to teaching English language arts to 10th and 12th graders, Hazel Witham coaches spoken word poetry at Venice High School. Hazel's work has been published in a variety of literary journals. One of her greatest joys in teaching is listening to her students' stories and nurturing a community in a classroom of readers and writers.
The thing that has kept me going every day of these last 19 years now, I guess, is the community and the family that a school becomes. I could not do this work without the incredible network of fellow teachers and support staff and administrators and the students themselves. I mean, this is the most community-minded work. You know, we really create a family on a school campus. And so my colleagues that were first year teachers with me in those early years, we would have lunch every day and we would share just the horrors of our school day, of like how we didn't understand how to reach a kid or we made such a mistake, and we would just process the work together. So the thing that's kept me going and motivated me is just the family of fellow colleagues and the overall school community. It's just a really magical place to be.
After 9 years as a first grade teacher, Daniel Calma is returning for his fourth year of teaching third grade. Dan has taught all levels between kindergarten and fifth grade at D.D. Johnson Elementary School for his entire teaching career of 23 years.
During one of our last Zoom meetings in the spring, I thought the kids would be excited to know that the year was coming to an end. And so I said, "Aren't you guys excited? We only have 10 more days." And all of a sudden I saw this blank look on my students' faces as we were meeting virtually. And then I said, "What's going on?" I said, "Aren't you guys excited?" And I saw one student do this, and then another student who doesn't really do much communicating with me, into the chat he said, "I am sad." And that to me was a really powerful moment, because I realized that these students of mine that I built this relationship with from the beginning of the year, and all of a sudden we were in separate buildings, how much they really needed that physical contact with other human beings, not just me, but with their peers. So it was a great lesson for me to learn, because I believe that we were doing okay, but I learned that virtual teaching, even though it's all we got right now, I got to do the best I can to reach out to those students and to connect in a different way. So as I'm teaching, I know I spend more time trying to connect with them and trying to get them to maybe smile a little bit more. And that way I know that they're connecting with me.
In her 6 years at Adams Middle School, Leslie Spainhauer has taught honors, general education, language arts, literacy, intervention, creative writing, theater production, and directed several school plays. She serves as an induction mentor for new teachers and as a department representative on the instructional leadership team.
Something that has helped motivate me and that I think about a lot is that students also feel really challenged by this. They are missing connections even more than I am. Their interactions with me and their interactions with their peers are really important, especially when you're 13 and friends are, you know, the most important thing to you in a lot of ways. So one thing that motivates me is knowing that being live in class on Zoom is something that the kids are looking forward to and that they want that interaction. And so I think about that as I'm getting ready for work. I also think a lot about what they are going to need in order to be successful next year. So thinking about how I can set up my lessons in a way that is going to prepare them for high school, make sure that they have learned what they need to learn this year, even though we're in difficult situations. It's a challenge, but I find challenges motivating. So that is another aspect that gets me excited to work to sort of confront the challenge and also overcome it.
Although Jim Klipfel has taught social studies for grades 7 through 12, he has gone above and beyond for his students as the swim and dive team coach, AP and Standard College Prep U.S. history teacher, Science Olympiad team leader, and director of the Habitat for Humanity Club. In addition, Jim also raises guide dogs and is a lifelong learner who contributes to student and staff programs and reforms.
The strategies that I've employed to help kids get through the challenges of growing up and the challenges of formal education is to connect with them and do two possibly opposite things. One is to make sure they're always challenged outside their comfort zone. I think one of the challenges of youth is to not be pushed enough, whether it's in areas of content or physical growth or relationships or personal stamina, good healthy choices with yourself, your own health and things like that, study habits, time management, to get pushed. The other side of that is to help people get back up on their feet when they have been pushed and they struggle. And if they've been taught that you've got to have A's, that you've got to be first flutes in your band section, that you've got to be first in your class, you have to be captain of the team, you have to make the musical, you have to have a date for the dance. Those are tough things growing up. So the combined effort of both of those is what drives me.
Congratulations to our top 10. There are so many people who are cheering for you today. And now let's hear from some special guests.
Hi, I'm State Senator Holly Mitchell, a proud product of LA County Schools. You know, the role of teachers are probably more important today than ever before. And so I want to pause and join with the LA County Office of Education and the Greater LA Education Foundation to tip my hat to the 2020 Teacher of the Year nominees. I wish you all the best. And again, take an opportunity to thank my favorite teachers who framed my life and shaped me and convinced me I could do anything I wanted to do. Miss Downey, fourth grade, Miss Morris, fifth grade, Miss Broussard, seventh grade math, and my BSU advisor in high school, Dale Roberts. To all the teachers and those who support young people, I applaud you.
Hello, this is Assemblymember Patrick O'Donnell representing Long Beach, Signal Hill, San Pedro, and Catalina Island up in Sacramento. I also serve as the chair of the Education Committee in the California State Assembly. And I'm also a veteran classroom teacher, like many of you. And today I want to take this opportunity to congratulate all our nominees. Again, all our nominees for the LA County Teacher of the Year. You are wonderful people who do wonderful things for children and do wonderful things for the state of California. Certainly, these are very trying times, but you and your colleagues have come through for California's children, and I can't thank you enough from the Sacramento level. But again, I want to note all the nominees today, and congratulations to all of you. And again, thank you for your hard work in the classroom and now behind the computer. This is Patrick O'Donnell from California State Assembly and Chair of the Education Committee, thanking you once again.
Hi, I'm State Senator Connie Leyva, representing the 20th Senate District in the Inland Empire. This past spring, schools and their staff, including teachers, transitioned to distance learning very quickly. Clearly, it was unexpected, but teachers have truly risen to the challenge, both then and now in the new school year. During this pandemic, teachers are our true heroes in helping our students learn under very trying circumstances. Beyond being teachers, they are also mentors and even serve as tech support, sometimes while also being a parent and teacher to their own children. I would like to join the LA County Office of Education and the Greater LA Education Foundation in thanking all teachers in LA County, and especially the 2020 Teacher of the Year candidates. You are all amazing, and I appreciate you from the bottom of my heart for everything that you do for all students up and down the state of California. Be safe and be well.
Congratulations on Teacher of the Year!
And you're even a better mama!
I can no longer count on my fingers the times you spent helping build our poems.
How many handwritten notes to nervous slam poets
reminded us that we were magic and rhythm. And like any good tune, we needed to be heard.
The gifted books and notebooks and coffee and pens, the sweet praises for poems that couldn't stand on two legs.
I gifted you a bright traditional Mexican shirt. You wrote a poem about not feeling worthy of wearing it. But I know, and every student who has walked through your doors knows, that you deserve each and every recognition that comes your way.
You told me I was good enough, though I didn't understand it yet. You wanted to hear my story because it mattered to you.
You wanted to hear my story because it mattered to you. And it never mattered to anyone else before.
And it never mattered to anyone before.
We love you, Miss Witham. Thank you for being the best.
So thank you, Miss Witham. And congratulations on the Teacher of the Year Award. Love you.
Congratulations, Mrs. Paliza. You are a true inspiration. We are so proud of you here at Keppel Academy. You've had many students over the years that wanted to share what an inspiration you've been to them, your hard work, your dedication, your work with the Girl Scout troops, reaching out to our community to help grow all of the programs here at Keppel Academy. Thank you so much, and congratulations.
Hi, Erica. Congratulations on being named Burbank Unified School District Teacher of the Year. I'm so thankful to have you as a teacher at Miller. Your positive attitude and energy is inspiring. Thank you for taking the time to get to know your students and for building a classroom community that encourages them to work together, be respectful to each other, and to care about one another. I know that it is important to you that your students are taught that they can make a positive contribution, not only in your classroom, but in the school, city, state, country, and the world. Congratulations on this well-deserved recommendation.
So Ms. Bainhauer, can I jump in for a moment?
Sure.
So I'm so sorry to interrupt parents, but this is the first time we've all been together in the same place to congratulate Ms. Bainhauer on being chosen as the RBUSD Teacher of the Year. We just want to say congratulations and how proud we are of her and how excited we are for her. So thank you for giving us this time to do so.
I want to jump into. Oh, there's Dr. Keller. Go ahead, Dr. Keller.
No, go ahead. I insist, Dr. Wesley.
Well, I was just going to add that, you know what this means? Mrs. Spadehauer is now going to represent us at the county level for the top spot at LA County's Teacher of the Year. So we have such a great representation.
So that means basically, Leslie, you've been already made it to the next round, which says a lot about you. I love that it's middle school, former middle school teacher and principal. And, you know, this is a special gift. If you can achieve at the middle school level, you can achieve anywhere.
Good love.
Congratulations.
Hello, my name is Martin Gomez, proud principal of Azusa High School. And on behalf of the Azusa High staff, we are extremely proud to announce Ms. Maria Sims, Teacher of the Year.
Congratulations, Maria Sims, challenger for the English language learners, top teacher leader, co-teacher, awesome math teacher here at Azusa High School. We celebrate you.
Ms. Sims creates a positive climate in the classroom where all students are encouraged to participate and become active members in the classroom.
On behalf of our Board of Education and the entire Azusa community, congratulations, Maria. You make us proud.
Hi, I'm Highland High School Principal Chris Grado, and we as an admin team are here to congratulate Tim Green on County Teacher of the Year. It's quite an accomplishment. We know you work really hard at your craft and what you've been doing with our students and all of the program that you've grown here at Highland High School. We congratulate you and look forward to many, many more years of touching a lot of students' lives and doing all you can to make our community and our school that much better. So congratulations, Tim. And from our whole team, congratulations.
Well deserved.
Hey, congratulations, Wendy. Super teacher. Yeah. Hey, so proud, so very proud of you, Wendy, and all your hard work and dedication and commitment to our students, our teachers, our staff. This is a great accomplishment for you. And on behalf of Sierra Vista High School and Baldwin Park Unified School District, we congratulate you and all your hard work and your services and dedication. You're an awesome teacher, and we only wish you the very best. So keep doing what you're doing, Wendy, and we're with you 100% all the way. Go, Wendy.
You're an excellent teacher, where this recognition is very worthy of you. Thank you for setting the example of having a strong work ethic and being a great team player, and for all your passion for the success of student achievement and social emotional learning.
Congratulations, Jim.
Especially to me, I know our department and everybody on campus in more ways than one. Thank you so much for all that you do for Saugus High School.
For the first time, LACO, in partnership with the Greater LA Education Foundation, has developed new program elements to elevate, celebrate, and invest in teachers. Together, we will develop a resource hub for strategies and best practices from Teacher of the Year educators, professional learning networks featuring Teacher of the Year honorees, and provide innovation grants available to teachers around LA County. Before we close, I'd like to introduce the foundation's president, Dr. John Garcia, to share an exciting announcement.
Hello, everyone. This is John Garcia, President of the Greater LA Education Foundation. We're proud to support the 2020 Teacher of the Year celebration. This year, the Los Angeles County Office of Education, in partnership with the Greater LA Education Foundation, has developed new program elements to elevate, celebrate, and invest in teachers. Together, we'll develop a resource hub for strategies and best practices from the Teacher of the Year educators and provide innovation grants available to all teachers around LA County. There's more information to come, so please follow us at www.greaterlaedfund.org to learn more. Thank you and congratulations to our LA County Teachers of the Year.
Thank thank you to all the superintendents, principals, school staff, and our teachers' families for joining us today. Congratulations again to all our teachers. Thank you for all that you do for our students every day. Your great innovations and new promising practices will last beyond COVID-19 and will benefit our students for many, many years to come. At LACO, we will continue to work hard to support you and provide your districts and schools the resources they need to support student success. Please join us in celebrating teachers throughout the year by sharing your favorite stories about teachers who've made a difference in your life.